Hey everybody, Hermana Balance. My name is Tahir Maya Infinite and welcome to my channel, Living Mayat. I am a spiritual teacher, medicine woman, healer, and a clinically trained therapist, and I integrate all of it. So if any of this information resonates with you, please go ahead and like, subscribe, and comment, and share. If you're interested in any of my healing offerings, please go ahead and check out the link below and sign up for your free consultation call. All right, so let's get into it. Let's just get right on in. Woo. And I took a deep breath for a reason, because what came to me today was, this is the collective message that came to me. And it said, I can't breathe. And what I gathered from that information was that people may be experiencing cabin fever right now. We're at the heat. We're at the heart of this entire situation. And anytime when there is panic, when there is a crisis going on, you can't breathe. So a lot of people are feeling restlessness. A lot of people are getting very anxious. A lot of people are over it. However, no matter how you're feeling, we're still in it. So it's like, how are you maintaining? So it's like, can you take the heat? Can you take it? And so I want to talk about, you know, how to maintain as a spiritual being. Because you remember, you're a spiritual being, and really understanding your emotions and how your emotions are part of, again, being in this human existence, but also being the observer of your emotions and not letting the emotions drive you back. And I say, like, relapse back into the program and literally just giving up. This is not time to give up. This is about really dialing in and stepping into the next level of your spiritual evolution and getting through any type of mental imbalances that are coming in, okay? And also recognizing that this new moon that is coming in on 422 is also stirring up some things, but it's also a reset. New moons are about resetting. It's about renewing. This moon is a wild pink moon. So that's also causing some restlessness. If you haven't tapped into that wild essence of your spirit. And it's like you're at an internal war. Like, there is internal warfare. Anytime where there's restlessness, there is an internal warfare going on, psychologically, spiritually. Can you take the heat? All right, so that's kind of where this conversation is going. So I want to talk about emotions and learning that you need your emotions in order to exist here. And you need to learn from your emotions. And when you become the observer of them, you no longer are a victim to them. Let me say that again. When you learn to become the observer of them, you're no longer a victim to them, which means that you have mastered your elements, the fire, the water. Remember, we are also elements. We are part of this system. Remember, we are co-creations of Mother Maya Earth. We are co-creations of her. So all these elements live inside of us. And when I think about the emotions, I think about also the elements. They just, for me, they just go hand in hand. And when it comes to restlessness, anxiety, it is usually connected to something of the past or something of the future, not being fully present. And then you're backtracking, you're going back and you're saying, I should have done this. I should have known. That was a mistake, right? But realize that mistakes are looking at that experience at a very linear level, because mistakes are connected to a lesson that you need to learn, that your higher self is trying to say, learn, please, so we could get to the next level of this. So anytime when you say, I made a mistake, or I wish, whatever, I wish I would have done this, what was the lesson there? Don't get caught up in that emotion of the mistake. Go behind that and figure out, what was the lesson there? Maybe you need to be more grateful. Maybe you need to heal something. You get what I'm saying? Everybody has to go through the lessons of life to really come back to self as a whole balanced being. So it's like, you need to get honest with yourself and recognize that if this loop keeps on coming back, it's only going to create more mistakes. So right now, this is traumatic, what's going on as a collective confirmation. This is a traumatic experience, what's going on. Okay, but that doesn't mean you get caught up in the trauma of it. You sit back and you recognize, okay, what is it that I need to learn within all this? If I'm feeling restlessness, if I'm feeling anxious, there's something that I need to learn, because they're turning up the heat, which means that you are feeling things possibly at a deeper level. If you're still psychologically stuck in a program. Now, hear me out here. When I talk about programs, I am talking about the division. If you're still divided in the mind, they have an opportunity to come in. And I say them as the system. Remember, there is always players, and it's up to you whether you become one of the players or be played. Right? So it's about understanding that when you are still plugged into a division, no matter if it's religion, politics, racism, those type of things, and you haven't started to declutter and mentally clear yourself from false conditioning, stepping into the free being that you are without those conditionings, when things like this happen, it triggers you psychologically. So it's like you can't even hear your spiritual being or your spiritual essence talking to you. You haven't integrated yet. So you're going to make mistakes. You're going to be stuck in your lesson. So now it's time to learn the lesson. Can you take the heat? Can you take the fire? Can you learn to control the fire by allowing yourself to be emotional, but not connecting to the experience? So now you're becoming the observer, right? So understanding that when you are angry and you are frustrated, it's okay. Okay? It's okay to be angry. It's okay to be sad. But when you get caught up in the loop of that emotion, it's not doing you any good. It keeps you in the loop, which keeps your external world looking more chaotic. Therefore, putting yourself into a victim state. Confirmation win. But that's what that is. So now it's about recognizing that you are the master of yourself, of these elements. But how do you master something? You experiment. You are going to make mistakes. But you come to the adept level and realize that the knowledge is within the lesson. And once you master that and you step into accepting the lesson, now you move on to the next level of your spiritual evolution. So all this mental imbalance or this mental health illness that is also part of the division, which I will get into in a whole nother video, but these stigmas around mental health illness causes you to disconnect from your spiritual evolution of self. So I trust that that makes sense. And recognizing that you are always supported by the cosmos. So this new moon that's coming in, it's a pink moon. It's a sensual moon. It's a sensual wild moon, which is also stirring up some frustration, especially if you are homebound and you don't have a partner. And I talked about Kundalini last time in my last video, and about how your Kundalini is your creative force, is your sexual force, and learning to tap in and again maintain the fire by expressing through creativity, through healing. If you need to heal, heal. But that is how you tame the element. That's how you tame the fire within. But if you just let it become chaotic, then it's hard for you to tame it. Just like a physical fire. So now it's about learning that you have control over how you deal with this stuff. Recognizing that. Not being the victim. Like recognizing you have a mind. You have thoughts. And you just, it's all about adjusting. And it does take mental endurance to do so. But accepting the lesson, accepting what's going on is part of it. Not being numb to it, but also not being a victim to it. So that whole I can't breathe message, when that came in, it was like people are starting to feel trapped inside of themselves. And now they are looking at them to free them, to allow them to breathe. Nobody should not have that much control over you that you can't breathe. And if they do, you need to work on letting go and surrendering and coming back in to your spiritual essence by working the lessons out. Remember, like I always say, there's levels. There are stages. Just like any game, there are stages. Recognizing which stage you're on and accepting the task. It's like playing a game, right? And of course, as you level up or level in or whatever you want to call it, it gets more challenging. So this is where you build that mental endurance. But you can't flow perfectly into the next levels. That is not even being an alchemist. Being an alchemist is understanding at all levels. There's an as above, so below. Mistakes will be made, and we're cool with it. Because we understand mistakes turn into lessons, which makes us masters when we learn the lesson. So, I trust that that makes sense. And this is where you also need to reach out to your support, reach out for help. Especially when you're feeling like you can't breathe and the world is coming to an end. And when people say that, it's like, no, your world is coming to an end, not my world. Your world is. And it's because you are allowing that energy to take over. There have been more people who not only relapsed in a spiritual sense, but also addiction at this stage. And it's because they're still functioning at a level of a child. And I said this before. We are children of this, but we're also adults too. And we need to understand that we have to function from both levels in order to maintain. So it's not about getting rid of the child. It's about understanding you're also an adult. Taking responsibility. Being the parent of yourself. So growing up. Coming into your wisdom. You know, that whole grandmother aspect of yourself. Stepping into that. But also honoring your child self. Honoring your curiosity. Honoring your adventurous ways. But balancing out the responsibility. Of knowing that as a collective, we got some growing up to do. And recognizing we are responsible for our own worlds that we choose to live in. So if you are constantly waiting for somebody to save you versus to guide you and help you, you're automatically giving them your power, giving them your freedom. And as a collective, that is the major problem. People have a hard time thinking for themselves. When people disagree with me, and it's okay to disagree with me, one of the things that I know when they are in a program is when they try to quote stuff from a book. This is what the Bible said. This is what the Quran says. This is what this guru said. And it's like, you can't even find your own words. Boo, you ain't thinking for yourself. Now, trust, we are all functioning underneath, I say one mind. I'm going to just call one mind just for conversation's sake. You may call it God. You may call it source, whatever. But, you know, it's like this energetic thing that I vision. We're being downloaded with the same energy, the same information, right? But unlike people who like to regurgitate information from other people, I trust in what's coming in and I express it. Now, you may have heard it in another way because we are all functioning underneath that one mind, but it's through my own creative expression, not from regurgitating something, writing it down, and quoting it from a book. So that's when you know that they are still afraid of their own truth. And where we're at with Mother Maya and all the other energies that are coming through is you need to think for yourself, boo. Start thinking for yourself. Grow up into yourself. It is time. She's done holding our hands. So can you take the heat and reach out to your support if you need it? But recognizing that nobody's coming to save you. You can only save yourself. All right. That's what I got for you. If you have any questions, any comments, please feel free to leave them. Other than that, I will see you in my next one.